We have seen before that tables are used for displaying a large amount of data. But there is another way we can use tables. We can use them for creating complex layouts for a page. This is a very important technique that you must learn. For example, I have a page I have created here with preview. You see something like a column over here. It's something that we cannot do it easily on a document without using tables. So let's close the preview. And you see the end result here. I have put all the contents in a table. So to show how to use the tables as a layout, let's try to replicate this example here. First, you have to have an idea of what you want to achieve and create your table and define the number of rows and columns you need. So now I'm going to need 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 10 rows and 2 columns. So first, create a table with the number of rows and columns you want, but choose the more options better, because we don't want a table to have heading and we don't want to have borders. So I insert my table over here and then I put my text. So I will just copy and paste. But there is a problem here. You see now my layout has this cell somehow merged. So after you create your table, then you have to refine your layout by merging or splitting your cells. So let's merge these cells over here with this button, like we learn in table layout. So and then you can continue putting your images, text or documents. And then you see this cell as well is being merged, so I have to merge this row over here. And then you can continue putting your text and formatting your table after you put some, for example, the text over here. Let's put some more text. And all of this. Then you can resize your table as we learn. Make it smaller. And from the table properties, change the alignment to the center. And so on. And if you print preview, you see that no border lines are printed. But sometimes you can use some borders like this. So let's say we have only a left border. Like this. And this is just a way of creating a layout. You can, of course, create your own layouts using tables.